Carol, the warden, was leading a clergyless service. She'd promised to pray for the new school year, and it would have been churlish not to be present, even if I wasn't quite sure what the Almighty, no doubt busy with Middle Eastern chaos and drowning asylum seekers, would feel able to do. He'd not yet found us a new vicar, a matter of at least as much moment as local education. But I found it incredibly moving to be mentioned by name, not just as the head of two schools now, but also as one whose new home had been violated with violence. I wasn't too sure about the combination of the words, but if God could be all-forgiving, I could too. A lot of people hugged me at the end of the hour. One kind woman even wiped away a smear of my mascara. It was time for my prints and gobswob to be taken. Not surprisingly, when shopping in Canterbury called me, I responded to its summons. I'd been misled by the gorgeous summer into forgetting about autumn clothes. Normally I shopped online for my clothes, but a real trip to actual shops seemed an attractive way of passing my last afternoon of freedom and taking my mind off a process I associated with criminal suspects. The place was unexpectedly busy, and parking tricky, even in the fairly capacious Whitefriars Centre's multi-storey. But park I did, and shop I did. I even had a very civilised lunch at Fenwick's, the last civilised midday meal I'd enjoy for a week. It was only as I left the Whitefriars Centre and hit the High Street that I understood the source of the problem. A rowdy march, led by a familiar face, was heading my way, with a larger number of vociferous people of all types objecting to their presence. And why not?